Education Ethics in an Open Access Journal. So we'll take this up one by one. First of all, how do you define ethics in publishing? I told you this last time that when we say ethics, we actually say ethically, morally, it should be a publication which you feel that you have done it yourself, you have done the work yourself. That's what you need to feel, first of all, that you have done the work yourself. Once you have that feeling yourself, you have done it yourself, you have not copied it, you have not taken the data from somewhere else, then you also need to see that you have not manipulated any data. You have not manipulated any data while you are writing any publication. That means you have not tampered with the data, you have not fudged the data. Then once you are yourself sure that you have maintained the integrity, the quality and the integrity of the publication, then you move to the next step. Then you go for manuscript submission. Now, what is the role of the publishing house? I have already defined you this, that their role is to maintain the ethics of the publication. They have to check that whether this publication is actually plagiarized or not. ये कहीं से कॉपी पेस्ट तो नहीं है. They have to check this. It's the role of the publishing house. And once they have checked it, then they actually go for reviewing of the. They actually go for reviewing of the publication. So these are the basic principles of publication ethics. And once they have some. Once your paper is actually accepted, it's ethical that the publishing house should actually give you the authority to have access as well as distribute. If you as a publisher, sorry, as an author, are not yourself able to get access of the paper once you have published it without subscribing, and you are not free to.
Sorry, sir, to interrupt. Sir, there's a student who want to join, but maybe you are not allowed. He's from computer science.
I was talking about it's. Ethical to give you, it's the role of the publisher that he has to give the author the right to access and as well as distribute. That's what ethics demand. Now, in publication ethics, what are the various other ethics that, first of all, I would go with the website. The first thing, I would go with the website. Now, there will be a journal's website. Now, it should contain and it should demonstrate that care has been taken to ensure it. There should be some written form that care has been taken to ensure that high ethics ethical standards have been maintained. They should come on the website. Ethical standards regarding what? Regarding it should have information which about the journal, what is the journal, what is its publishing house, it should have information about the journal, about its publishing house. Then it should also show us website pe hona chahiye, site score mention hona chahiye on the website. But it could also have information about other parameters like SSR, SSJ, its H index, its impact factor. But there should be no information. I will mark this red. There should be no information about ki hum aapko 10 din mein ji paper, 10 days mein, 10 days for paper publishing publish karke denge. Now, if this information is provided on the website of the journal or the publishing house or any other manuscript submission, like in a book or anything else, कि हम आपको 10 दिन में पेपर सब पब्लिश करके देंगे, 5 डेज में आपको रिव्यू करके देंगे, then this is not an ethical standard. You cannot ensure कि आप 10 दिन में पेपर पब्लिश कर सकोगे और 5 दिन में रिव्यू कर सकोगे एंड ऑल्सो मेंटेन द क्वालिटी ऑफ द पब्लिशिंग. So this is not an ethical standard. So such things have to be maintained even in all journals, including in open access journals. As well as all journals should ensure that this. Now, there should be further information like ISSN number hona chahiye. Now it's a book, ISBN number or IBN number should be provided on the website of the pub journal. Now it should clearly give you authorship, the house, the publication house or the journal should actually give you authorship ki ye kiske naam pe authorship hai. You cannot agar multiple submissions aap ek hi journal mein kar rahe ho, if you are submitting multiple submissions, then the question of copyright has to be taken into care, whether the submission being done in the same journal, whether it's again being copyrighted within the same journal itself. To wo maintain karna hai. Jo bhi aapke sare redundant publications hai, which are actually lapsed publications, all the redundant publications, they have to be got off they have to be got off from the list, from the website. वो archives में जाने चाहिए. So this is the first thing that the publishing house should maintain, such that the ethics as well as transparency, a very important word, transparency of publishing is maintained. ऐसा नहीं है कि आपने कहीं पर पब्लिश किया और वो एक्सेस नहीं प्रोवाइड कर रहे हैं. इफ नाउ इट्स एन ओपन एक्सेस जर्नल, दे हैव टू प्रोवाइड एक्सेस, बट दे हैव नॉट मेंटेन दीज क्राइटेरियाज, दे हैव नॉट साइटेड द स्कोर, द एसएसजी, द एच इंडेक्स. नाउ व्हेन यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस इंपैक्ट फैक्टर एंड अदर्स, व्हाट इज द सोर्स? There are only two or three sources which are very important. It's either Scopus, which is SCI, it's Thomson Reuters. And one or two more, which are actually giving you the, they should cite these. The publishing house has to cite this on the website, that these are the indexing agencies. Now, the basic thing is that the publishing house should not give you false information. Yes, sabse important cheez hai. It should not give you false information. Again, in red. Now, for example, there are certain publishing houses which say that they are Scopus index. वो कहते हैं कि हमारी publication Scopus index है, but actually, once you look up into Scopus, it's not there. When it's not there, that actually means that the publishing house is giving you the false information. So, for you as authors, as researchers, what you need to maintain is that either you go look into Scopus. It's, first of all, you look into Scopus. Then there is a Scopus website. I can show you if it opens. So this is the Scopus website. You actually need to go into this website. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
This is a Scopus website. You have to give the title of the journal here. For example, I'm giving some journal name. You have to go and check into the journal whether this is in the Scopus. Now, this is in the Scopus. You might be looking for any other journal like International something. There are so many like International Journal of Engineering. Now, International Journal of Engineering Science may be there, but International Journal of Engineering and Technology may not be there. While as when you go, you might go into that journal's website, it might show you that it's Scopus index. So you have to check into from the source itself. Then there is another source, which is Web of Science. This is Web of Science. Let me again show you. So this is the website title, mjl.clavery.com, that then you actually are searching here in the Web of Science master journal list. You are searching it here, whether your journal is in the list. So the publishing house might give you wrong information that they should not do. If they are doing it, then they are not following the best practices which are in the publishing, and they are not maintaining the ethics of publishing. Now, the second thing is, this was about, first thing was about mentioning on the website. The second thing is about the name of the journal. Now, why does the name come from? The name is actually taken by the editors of the journal. Now, that name should be actually unique. It should not be cloned. It should not be replicated to. So while you are accessing any open access journal or any journal for that matter, it should not be cloned, it should not be replicated. The name should be unique as such. Now, that should not be confusing. Now, you have a publication in any journal which might actually mislead the people. Which is actually misleading the people, and it's causing problems for the authors as well as readers. It's causing problems for authors as well as for readers. Now, for example, you have the name as of certain journal as International Journal Engineering Sciences. Now, this is a well-known journal. International Journal of Engineering Sciences. Now, there is somebody else who comes up with the journal name as International Journal of Engineering Sciences. Now, this could be very well misleading for authors as well as for readers. They might tend to get that this journal is actually the one which is in the Scopus or in the SCI, while as it's not. So they are actually misleading both the authors who are submitting it as well as the readers who are reading it. Now, this has to be maintained by the publishing house. Now, the third thing, which I discussed briefly last time, let me go into detail, is about the peer review process. There are so many journals who claim that they are peer reviewed. Peer review, what does it mean? It means that it's reviewed by taking advice from individuals or from certain experts in that area. So based on that, what is done is that once you take the advice from individuals, from certain experts, they give you the comments. Based on that, manuscript is, which is submitted in some journal, is actually got published, actually reviewed, revised, and then published. Now, this process of peer reviewing, first of all, the journal should write whether it's peer reviewed or not. But there are many journals who actually mention this, that they are peer reviewed. But at the same time, they mention that the journal publishes, which I just told you, publishes in 10 days. And at the same time, they ask you for publishing cost, faster publications. They give you this incentives that it's a faster publication. They ask for publishing cost. Now the journal which claims that it publishes in 10 days asks for publishing costs and say that the publishing happens faster. Now that cannot be peer reviewed, because peer reviewed goes to at least three reviewers, and each reviewer has to read and then submit the comments. And once the comments come, they go for revision to the author. And when the author again revises, then it's again goes to the reviewer for final judgment or for second reviewing. So faster publication and at the same time saying that it's going through peer review process, such journals do not follow the publishing ethics. And for actually clarifying whether, this is peer reviewed or not, what you need to do is that, or the any researcher or the author should do, is that he should ask publishing house for providing list of referees. Referees are actually the reviewers, for providing the list of referees for different publications. Down in that journal. So in peer review process, you actually need to ensure that wherever you are publishing, it's being published in a very good manner, by considering that there are referees or reviewers and the publication is happening after taking due consultation and comments from the reviewers. So this is about the peer review process. Now there should be, yes, there should be one thing more mentioned, that the journal itself should not guarantee that the manuscript acceptance and very short peer review time. which I just described to you, that it should not mention that it publishes in 10 days. Then the fourth point comes to be ownership and management. Now, there should be an information clearly about the ownership and the management of the journal. For example, editor's name should be mentioned. Editor or editor's name should be mentioned there. Then the various the journal could mention the reviewers, although it's not important, but they could mention the reviewers list. Which I told you just now, ownership also deals with the name of the journal, this one. Now, when you are owning a journal, you cannot claim a journal with cloned names of leading journal publications. There have been many such journals which have been actually barred or debarred, which have been told to be not only publishing plagiarized publications, but also so the plagiarized journals, the journal itself should mention that our papers are not plagiarized. There have been many journals which were plagiarized. They have been now delisted from various platforms. So, and you are quite aware that in India, we have UGC, which is actually defining now a care list. And this UGC care list has got two care lists, care list one and two. Now, in care list one, there are 9,000 plus journals. It defines which are the actual peer-reviewed journals. In care list two, you have, this is in the first care list. In care list two, we have around, we have thousands more from Scopus and Web of Science and our Science Citation Index. So these are the sort of journals that go for that have to be taken into account when we are actually publishing and owning the ownership and the management of a certain journal. Then the next point comes to be about the governing body, which is the governing body for that journal. Now, each journal should have an editorial board, which I just mentioned. It should have an editorial board. Then there should be certain co-editors as well. Then a governing board which decides about policy of publishing. Now, all these members need to be experts in the field. Now, if the governing board has got a member like editor who is from any other field and he's publishing, he's owning a journal of certain other field, then that governing body is not authentic. And you cannot claim that journal is authentic. Is rather than saying authentic, is following the ethics of publishing. It cannot be that the editor is from some other field and he's owning a journal from any other field. This is where we stop in this lecture. In the next lecture, we'll be talking about further processes of checking the transparency and the standards of publishing in any open access journal. Why are the publication ethics more important in open access journal? Because when we are talking about open access journal being accessible to everybody, they without coming with a subscription cost, the journals or the publication houses, they tend to go with publishing in such a way such that they earn more. तो उसमें ये हो जाता है कि एथिक्स